Without a doubt, the question I get asked more than anything on this channel is, how do you save your shirt designed for printing or for your client or manufacturer? So today's video, I'm gonna show you how I do it. Let's go. Yo, what is good, guys? It's your boy Dixon from Intuitive Designs. Welcome back to the channel, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't yet for more content like this every week. All right, so first of all, if you're preparing your design for your client or a manufacturer, it is best if you just ask them for the printing guides, because a lot of these print shops have their own requirements. So really it depends on the kind of machine that they use. But generally, if we were to prepare for a very generic DTG printer, this is how you do it. For this tutorial, I'm using this design file as an example. It is my own design that I made a couple of months ago. Also, the software that I'm using is Adobe Photoshop 2023. The file size is 5000 by 6600 pixels. It falls somewhere in between A3 and A2. Now, the reason why I do that is because if the client wants to print A2, I can just scale up the size without losing too much detail. Now, the most common print size for DTG is A3, which is 11.7 by 16.5 inches. If you're using a print-on-demand company like Printful, that is pretty much the only size that they offer, for the t-shirts at least. Occasionally, if you have the budget and you find a manufacturer that prints A2, then by all means go for it. But bigger print area means bigger cost, so keep that in mind. Okay, so back to it. The best resolution or DPI for printing is 300 DPI. Anything that goes above that won't make a difference at all, other than having the file size bigger, which you don't want. You know, you want the file size to be as small as possible so that you can send it to your client faster without sacrificing the quality, of course. So 300 is the way to go. Now give it a second to do its job. And here we go. Now, this is how it typically looks like for a shirt design file in PSD format. You have your assets and effects in separate layers, and you can toggle them on and off like this. So for printing, you want it to merge into one layer. So what you do is hit Option Command E on your keyboard to flatten the layer into one, into a separate layer, I mean. Now, it's not Command E because that convert the group layer that you have selected into a flattened single layer. Then you lose the ability to edit the design in case you need to in the future. So let me do that again. Option Command E to save as a separate layer and not Command E. Okay, now we're gonna turn off all of these layers, especially the black background, because we don't want it to show up on the shirt when we get it printed. We want the design to have a transparent background without any black rectangle box behind it. Okay, so let's just delete all of these layers, because in the end we'll be saving it as a separate new file anyway, so it won't matter. Okay, so now we're gonna get rid of these unused pixel area. Now, reason why is that we want to maximize the print area. If I'm printing it like this, the design will come out a bit smaller as opposed to something like this. Now, there's a couple of ways that we can fix that. We can either Command T and then size up the file like this, but then we still have the unused pixels on the left and right, or we can use the crop tool to crop it, but it won't be as precise. So the best way to do it is go to Image and select Trim. Now, in this Trim window, under the Base Start section, select Transparent Pixel, and under the Trim Away section, make sure that all sides are checked, and then just hit OK. And it will automatically do it for you. Easy, quick, and precise. Next is the color profile. Just go to Image, Mode, and select the color profile as your client or manufacturer requests. In this case, we're gonna leave it as RGB because a lot of DTG printers now can print sRGB, which is better because the color gamut of CMYK is quite limited compared to RGB, which has wider color range that goes way beyond the CMYK gamut. I think Printful does a good job explaining that, so you can check the article out for full explanation. Final step, I'm gonna save the file as a new file. Go to file and then select save a copy, not save as or save. It's this one right here. Select where you want to save it on your computer, name it whatever you want, and then save the format as PNG. Now this is one of the only two formats that allows transparency. It is also relatively small and sustain the quality of the image very, very well. But then again, some manufacturer would ask for a PDF. In that case, you can just save it as PDF based on the settings that they want. In this format option, we're just gonna select the first one and you're all set. Now, if you open the file, you can see that it's got transparent background, and which is exactly that we want. So when you do get it printed, it will come out something like this mockup right here. That is all for today, guys. This is a very basic tutorial, but I feel like I needed to explain it anyway for those who didn't know. Subscribe so you don't miss out on my videos every week. See you in the next one.